Heavy Metal Kitchen. Today we are talking about Night Songs. This band had been around since 1983, had a different lineup, and this was their first claim to fame here for Pat's Dogs, two locations in Philadelphia. Check it out. Songs like how
being
many
that this 1985 from the set list mirrors the album
version,
I would assume the band was writing together and it wasn't just Tommy Kiefer.
Night Songs features 10 of the most kick-ass songs I can think of. I got it from Columbia House Records, thank God. They sent me that one and a bunch of other ones, and it was just such a treat. And my friend Maria and I got really into them, and we ended up going to their concert. That was my first concert when Cinderella opened up for Bon Jovi on the Slippery When Wet tour, but I'll get into that in a minute. Night Songs came out on August 2nd, 1986, produced by Andy Johns. Now, Cinderella had a different version. Cinderella began in 1983 and featured Tony Destra, Michael Shermick, who's known as Michael Kelly Smith from Britney Fox, as well as Tommy Kiefer and Eric Brittingham. So this is the version that used to play at New Jersey, the Galaxy and the Empire Rock Club in the Northeast Philadelphia. And they were from the suburbs. Sadly, Tony died in an automobile accident. And then around that was in 1987, but before this was released, Tony and Michael were, I think the record company didn't want them, Mercury. So they were replaced, Tommy Kiefer, Eric Brittingham, Fred Corey on drums, and Jeff LaBar on guitar. Don't forget,
Gary
Harris was also part of the band, keyboards, although he's never featured on any album covers. And so Mark Weiss did this one as though it were nighttime. From the looks of this album, it looks like they are a typical glam band of that time, which is not at all true. They were quite the opposite. They were really good. They had a rockin' feel like AC/DC, but a little bluesy too. And you can especially hear that in track one. Track one starts with Night Songs. Now, that song starts with, you can hear like atmosphere, bells, the bells go off. I don't know, like you're at some kind of harbor, and he goes right into the riff, and I think it's excellent. I love it. Probably one of my favorite on the album. In fact, I remember being at that concert, and now that was not the first song. The first song was not until we get a little further into it, but I just remember hearing that in concert, looking around and just feeling like I was in some sort of, I don't know, it just felt so right. That was such a special concert. We had my friend's brother had taken us from, you know, my friend Maria and I were only 12 or almost 13, and John took us, he was about 18, and he took us, we had to pay his gas money and we had to pay for a ticket for him. But I remember having to wash cars to in order to do this because nobody wanted to take us. But he did, and I hope he had a good time. He's not with us anymore, unfortunately. Rest in peace, John. But he did, he took us, and I just remember getting to our seats and hearing those songs, and it was just like magic. Shake Me. And there's a really good version out there, is the original version, the 45. Before Cinderella was signed, they had a 45 out, and they tried to send it to different record companies and whatnot, and in fact, I'm surprised Gene Simmons doesn't take credit, because he actually discovered them, one of the first that discovered them, before John Bon Jovi, because everyone knows John Bon Jovi discovered them. I think most people do. But it was Gene Simmons. But for some reason, he didn't follow up on it. And it was John Bon Jovi that figured out that, you know, he would say to the record companies, no, you got to see them live. You don't, you know, don't listen to the demo. See them live. It's more accurate. But anyway, so these 45s have been released since, I don't know, a few years ago. And they're pretty good. Track three, we have Nobody's Fool. And that's the better of the two. That was the second side of the 45. And I think that is just the best version. I don't know why they changed it. The really good rocking second half of it here with the original members, Tony and Michael Kelly Smith. Next track after that is Nothing for Nothing, and that's a pretty good track. Then John Bon Jovi sings back up, and then on track five we have Once Around the Ride. Now that's a really special one because I remember coming into the concert during that song, which was the first song of the evening when Cinderella opened for Bon Jovi at the Spectrum. And I remember trying to get to our seats, and man, what a crowd, what a great crowd. It was just, that night was so magical, and there was just lighters everywhere, and it was just such a great vibe. They had sold out three nights in a row, and it was a big deal. And I remember articles in the paper saying, you know, that Cinderella pretty much, you know, was the hit of the show, which is the truth. They were definitely on fire that night. Hell on Wheels. I like that song. I don't think there's any filler in it. Some people complain it's like too full of filler, and I don't hear that. I think they're great songs. I think they're all really good. Third single then is Somebody Save Me. And there you can see, these videos were so funny. I didn't talk about them before, but they all seem to follow this vibe, which is a young Cinderella and the stepsisters. This one, we actually see them the third time with their clock hats, which okay, I never guys, quite understood that. But anyway, and we also see John Bon Jovi and Richie Sambora, as well as the producer, Andy Johns. And they look a little annoyed as they're trying to cut an album. Kind of a weird storyline, but I thought it was cool for the day, you know, for that time. Didn't seem cheesy then. Seems a little cheesy now, but so what? Next one is In From the Outside, and that's another one where we hear John Bon Jovi doing backing vocals. Yeah, In From the Outside, that's another one I think it's up, right up there with Once Around the Rock. I'll take that one. And also Push Push, another great one, and I think that's what ended the show. We have Back Home Again, and that song, yeah, I can't even pick out my favorite tunes, because that's definitely one of them. Real heavy. I love the guitars in Back Home Again, especially how they're both kind of harmonized together. I think that's a really cool sound. It's definitely a killer track, and this album is so underrated. I love every song on it, and I often wonder. Had Michael Kelly Smith and Tony stayed, and how would this album sound? So if anyone else knows any more tidbits about this, I'd love to do it. I'd love to talk about these clubs and these times, because it really was a great time to be a teenager and, you know, have the Empire Rock Club and, you know, Sunday All Ages. It was fun. I only got to do it a few times because of my age, and my parents weren't really keen on me going out at night too much. So I only got a few chances, but I do remember the cell block, and I remember getting into some of the clubs like the Velvet Lounge on the Northeast. And it was just really good times and original music, and people were really into it, and it was really special. So I'm thankful I have these memories, and I'm thankful for getting this album and really enjoying it, because I really have, and I still enjoy it very much to this day. So thanks for watching, and I'm going to update an old recipe of mine. It's actually the first video I've ever did on here for zucchini casserole. And it's really good. I know it sounds kind of plain, but it's such a good, easy, healthy recipe. Revised some of the ingredients. So I hope you enjoy it. And I hope you enjoy this album as much as I do.